It's What If Wednesday time with Susan Bennett Fisher and Martin Fisher, co-founders of Body of Nine.
What if you found your purpose? What if you knew your purpose? And even if you know your purpose now, what if you could deepen it and access it through your body?
Today is going to be quite a philosophical discussion because many people out there that perhaps don't feel they need a purpose or don't want a purpose or the concept of even having a purpose is foreign. And that's perfectly okay.
And some people have very clear purposes from very young ages.
And I actually didn't have my purpose until 2012. So it varies quite dramatically around the world, by individual, by family, within groups. What is the history? What is the culture? And some purposes are culturally driven, some purposes are individually driven.
Some are driven by our families.
Yes.
And they do change. So you might start out in life with one particular purpose and then have that purpose change dramatically.
And, you know, in different parts of your life, different parts of the purpose, maybe self-purpose, maybe family purpose. And that's part of the fun, if you will, sometimes in life, is that every different sections of your life, your purpose may change.
But what I think we'll focus today on is the purpose that comes with your natural number. Each of the natural numbers has a function. So, you know, we have nine centers in our body, and one that one that is born active truly informs how we experience life. And you can see it everywhere in your life once you know it, about it. And I don't think that's just the, you know, the research effect of, you know, wanting to validate this showing up, because it literally is everywhere.
And so there's some, you could say, little p purpose. Natural number five, for example, part of our purpose is helping other people achieve something, who knows what, whatever that sort of part of the culture sits on top of your nature. But there's also me as Martin. I have a big p purpose. Part of my big p purpose is helping people understand about Body of Nine, and specifically for me, helping people know that there is a spiritual component to us all, even with your, if your natural number is an even number or an odd number. So the scale of purpose also varies. Each of us has a natural number that helps us do something. And that is the almost subconscious, unconscious purpose that just is part of your life. It's part of your superpower.
We had the beautiful experience at being at the memorial this weekend for a friend of ours who had natural number seven. And everywhere you looked in that memorial of her life was the expression of her creativity, her exploration, her way of putting color together in different ways in all aspects of her life, both with actual color, but also the people. And every person who stood up, what they honored in my friend was the attributes related to her natural number sevenness.
Yes. And I think we have found that the people that are currently happy before we introduce natural numbers into their lives are already doing their natural numbers purpose.
In some way.
And that's fantastic. And yes. I think, you know, part of the happiness equation is, are you doing what your natural number purpose is, or are you doing what somebody else told you your purpose should be?
Right. Because that can be very painful.
Yes.
Yes. If you're doing something you think should be your purpose, but it actually isn't.
Yeah.
And again, I like your big P versus little p. There are the purpose related to each of the natural numbers is fairly well defined, as it turns out. So natural number one, the purpose is to help us know that we have value as a human being. For two, it's to understand that we have that engagement and connection and enliven our world.
And these are all the little P's. These are the things that your natural number does just by you being you. And that's fantastic.
Little P's?
Yeah.
These are some ways they're the big P's too.
Well, yes, but...
But I think we should say all nine of them.
We will, but I just wanted to point out that this is what your body does as part of your natural number. It is the purpose that your body has.
It's the
natural purpose. Great phrase. This is your natural purpose.
So it comes with you no matter what you do.
Yes. But you may strive to have a conscious personal purpose that is a superset, or is a that your natural purpose allows you to do more effectively.
Right.
So back to number three, I apologize.
Oh, no worries. So three, the purpose is to enliven our and turn on our soul and get us moving towards that direction. And four is about authenticity and deep web of connection, knowing that we are all connected at the life force level and helping us to know that we have value in the moment and that we are accepted, that we and can accept each other.
And natural number five is very much about providing space for people to grow into what us as natural fives know they can grow into.
And six, it's about waking everybody up, moving things in the right direction, and in alignment with the universal will.
Seven is about improvement. It's about knowing what doesn't serve you, knowing what does serve you, and giving those messages to help people actually achieve their natural purpose, funnily enough.
Yes, very important. Mm-hmm. And eight is how do we make all this real in this world? How do we use the suit that we've been given our body to understand what matters and how to do things in an inclusive and safe way?
A trustworthy way.
Yeah.
Yeah. And nine is about making sure that everyone's included, making sure that there is a balance in the world, making sure that things start and things end, and that we work without force. And yet, we could go through and get all nine again and describe a different set of natural practices, natural desires, natural abilities, because where we're going in our lives and the words we use for each of you and what you choose as part of your purpose, it's all wrapped up. And our advice is check into what is your purpose. And make sure that your purpose is not being given to you by somebody else.
And that your underlying natural purpose is being honored in whatever it is you are doing.
And so for every phrase that we said, for every natural number, everybody else is going to be saying, well, that's kind of mine too, perhaps, or I don't get that at all. And that's because the words are a little slippery. So check in with your body. What is it that your body supports you in doing?
And where do you find ease and joy and happiness?
Because all of us can do anything within limits. But how we do it.
And whether we enjoy it.
And whether we enjoy it.
And whether it feeds us at the level of our nature.
Yeah. I could go off and I could spend my time wanting to connect with people and spend all my time just chatting with people, building networks and those things. I would find it hard and I wouldn't be that good at it. But I could do it.
But our friend that we were visiting this weekend, that was basically his job.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Networking, creating connections, making sure that all parties were heard in a transaction. And it was just super suited to his nature. So he's never had any problem enjoying what he does.
Yes. Yeah. And again, going back to each of us could do anything. And the lucky ones among us have been able to find things that support our purpose. But I would offer that everyone can find jobs that support their purpose or at least give meaning to their lives
or
once they know what that is.
Right, or get that structure into the job that they need that supports their natural purpose. So there's kind of two layers to this. I want to talk about motherhood and the purpose of motherhood.
That's probably something you're uniquely qualified for.
I think that women who choose to be mothers go through a period when their purpose is completely wrapped up in their children. And that is one of the things I think that makes that empty nesting experience very challenging for women. And another reason I think that women somewhere around the age of 40 go through a experience of saying, hey, maybe my life has more purpose than I've been living into up to this point. And when that could be whether you procreated a family or procreated a career or wherever you put your procreative energy. But it's not uncommon for women to wake up somewhere around 40 years old and say, huh, maybe this isn't everything.
So this sort of goes back to what I'm going to call situational purpose that we were talking about earlier. Whether you have children or not doesn't mean you don't have a purpose. It means that your purpose is going to be different and your focus could be different.
Well, yes, and I there's both timing part of that, right? I look at 28 to 30, 44-ish as a period of time where we're procreating, we're creating what it is we're going to leave behind at some level. Although that nowadays, fortunately for us, comes later in life as well. So the shift.
Or not, but yes.
Yeah, or not. Yeah, depending if we're lucky to live a long life. So, but one thing that I do want to underscore is that to create a life of purpose, you have to do something of purpose every day. So you have to get to the end of the day and say, I did something that matters to me. In order for your life to have mattered when you hit whatever day that is, that it, that your suit wears out.
And that doing something for you may involve doing something for somebody else. It doesn't have to be you focused, but it needs to feed your soul. It needs to be in this way there. And I had this conversation before that as a five, I always anticipate Susan's needs. And I love doing that. It actually fulfills part of my purpose to fulfill what Susan needs me to do. And if I looked at it as a burden, then I wouldn't feel warm. I wouldn't feel fulfilled. I wouldn't feel that I'm actually doing my purpose. But when I realize that it's how I can support Susan, and by supporting Susan, that supports me, and by supporting us, we support you, then it actually feels really good to do what I do. And so some of it is intentional. Some of it is situational. Some of it is how you can view your life, because no life is good all the time. The lucky of us have more good than bad, but your attitude connects to your purpose.
And I want to go back to it. There was a lot of learning from this weekend. We flew to Boston for this memorial and spent some time with some very old friends. One of the things that came out of it for me is that until that natural purpose is acknowledged in what you're doing and being, mm-hmm. it's a lot harder to be happy.
Yes.
There's some fundamental switch that occurs when your natural number is active and you are doing things in alignment with your nature.
Because I've had situations, probably all of us have, where one of my bucket list items, or a series of bucket list items, have been able to be crossed off. And there was a certain joy in crossing off the bucket list, but that wasn't part of a happy life. I have a much happier life now than I did 20 years ago. And the situation that I was in 20 years ago was very different, both emotionally and financially, than it is now. But I'm way happier now than I was way back then.
Why?
Because I have my purpose. Mm. And I'm doing it with somebody I love. Both
little P and big P.
Little P and big P.
Little P and big P.
And situational purposes change too. And we continually increase, honestly, the size of our situational purpose. The more that we do this work, the more that we realize that we can have an impact, the more that it feels good to feel like we're having an impact. And on that note, I'm going to tease something that we're going to be talking about next week, because we found some really amazing things this weekend. And we're very excited about it. And the more that we talk about it internally and ready to present this to you guys next week, the more that we realize that the situational purpose, and when we're on purpose in our lives at any situation, whether it's wanting to become a teenager, whether it's wanting to go to school, whether it's wanting to get your first job, whether it's wanting to build a family, our bodies respond specifically to help us in those purposes. And if you know your natural number, how your bodies respond to those situations changes, literally changes. So we've got some exciting things to talk about in a week or so.
Yeah, it turns out there's much more both there's even more physiological.
Physio-spiritual, yeah.
There's more tie between our physical and our spiritual than is commonly thought of.
Yes.
Out in the world. And we're finding those ties between our physical and our spiritual because of the research that we're doing.
Yeah.
And so going back to purpose, separating your purpose from yourself and your nature and your natural purpose really causes a very powerful disconnect.
Yes.
So if you take on a purpose that is actually not aligned with your natural purpose, you will get exhausted.
And ill, potentially. I mean, there is beginning to be some evidence that your environment has a huge effect on your physical health, not to mention, obviously, your mental health, and obviously, not so obviously, perhaps your physio-spiritual health.
Which brings in this whole idea of consciously creating the world that you would like to live in. You know, and that's from, again, there's small to big. It's, for me, I have to consciously create an orderly environment for my sickness to be able to actually do its job. If it's too chaotic, it's very hard for me to do my job. here in this space that we're working, for example, you can't see it, but it's full of stuff. So I have to stay very focused energetically on specifically what we're doing right here on this camera. And then I can function beautifully. Mm-hmm. But unless I can actually focus on what is in alignment with energetically with the space, I have a very hard time doing the job that I came here to do.
And I have to get the space running before we can do this job. So as a five, there's 20 things that I have to make sure we're working before we can give you a situation, give you an experience that you enjoy as much as we enjoy giving it to you. So purpose, we all have so many purposes, but the ones that support us and the ones that we acknowledge that are in alignment with our natural number.
And bring happiness and
bring
joy.
Happiness and joy and health.
And health.
To us. So.
Right. Because when we're happy and joyful, we make better choices.
Yes.
When we typically make better choices on how to care for ourselves. Yeah.
Because once you get into despair, it's very hard to make a good choice under despair. And it's very hard to make good choices all the time. And it's okay not to make a good choice. We're not perfect human beings. None of us are. And not all our choices are going to be good choices. But knowing your natural number helps you communicate with your body, your physio-spiritual entity, your cosmic observer.
And make good choices.
And make good choices. And know quickly when the choices aren't good. Because part of the joy of getting older and experience is that, okay, you realize what's not a good choice a lot earlier than you would before.
Yes, because the implications of bad choices have more power later on in your life.
Yes, that's
true. They do.
It's harder to recover from a bad choice as you get older.
That's it's true. Yes.
Yes.
So whether you're 12, 24, 36, 48, or
60, it's 12, mate, but yes,
your choices affect your life.
Yes. And we have hundreds of examples where people have had their natural number identified, realized that the choices they've been made have not been serving them and they've not been in alignment with their purpose and have changed their job. Have found a better purpose and living a happier life. It's one of the reasons we say within 6 months to a year, you'll feel happier and more on purpose.
Right. And the other thing that really always continues to strike me is that it's predictable. There's a predictable quality that comes with your natural number in terms of what you care about, your behavior to a certain extent, although that's much more heavily influenced by our nurture. But the purpose, or the energy of the purpose, the structure of the purpose, the container of the purpose, the direction of the purpose, all those things. I think I'm using a lot of six words there.
Yes.
I was trying to come up with other ones, but the purpose varies in so many ways, but it is founded on your natural number.
And
your body.
And your body. And the next stage of that is understanding the people around you. If you understand your purpose, great. If you understand the underlying purpose of your family, your loved ones,
and how to support each one of them in their unique direction.
Yeah.
Then, so powerful.
Yeah. And just being able to expect results, or expect reactions. There's a predictive nature of knowing people's natural number that helps you say, well, okay, in this situation, this is how people could respond. And so you can build an amazing multi-person purpose. And that's one of the things I think the sevens are really good at. One of the things that we learned from this weekend is that there were three or four different groups of purposes that our friend had set up and was still running because one of her gifts of seven was helping set up group purposes, you will. Now, this is a new way of describing a goal, but a goal is really a group purpose that people sign up for.
Right.
Yeah.
A structure.
Yeah.
And sevens are good at building community around a vision or a purpose.
Yes.
And creating that container and attracting the right people into it. And we experienced that this weekend, seeing all of the communities that Kaki had created around the purposes in her life.
Right.
Yeah.
So this one's for you, Kaki.
Yeah, this one's for you, Kaki. We miss you.
Be well.
And just remember, every day makes a difference.
To you and the people around you.
Find that purpose.
Find those people.